Five on Your Health Now, a major breakthrough tonight in HIV and AIDS research. Mm-hmm. A patient is in remission after undergoing a stem cell treatment.
It's already worked once before, and right now experts from Boston are at a conference in Seattle to learn more.
I think this is really very important.
Dr. Daniel Koritzkis has been involved in AIDS research at Brigham and Women's Hospital for more than 25 years. He says today's announcement about a possible treatment ranks high on hope.
I think this discovery really tells us that a cure or at least long-term remission is possible.
Here's why researchers think they're onto something. 12 years ago, doctors used a stem cell transplant to successfully treat a cancer patient who was also infected with HIV, the virus that causes AIDS. The transplant altered the patient's immune system, making him resistant to the virus. Doctors were finally able to replicate that success with a cancer patient from London, and 18 months after his transplant, there's no trace of the virus.
And so this case is really very important in that it shows that by interrupting the receptor that the virus uses to get into the cells in a patient, that it can, in fact, be stopped.
Right now, stem cell transplants are only approved for patients with certain forms of cancer, but the discovery could still lead to new solutions for healthier patients.
It points the way towards other similar approaches that might be explored and applied more safely to a larger number of patients.
Some of the research is already underway at the Brigham's lab in Cambridge.
I don't think this will immediately change what we're doing except to make us redouble our efforts.
Researchers announced their success with this second patient in the journal Nature, and they plan to hold a press conference later tonight in Seattle.